Hello and welcome to Let's Play CubeVR. In case you don't know what CubeVR is, there is a little video that explains it a bit, and today I will show you the basics of CubeVR as well. So I hope you will stay with me and enjoy this piece of art, what this game is. And I actually have a German Let's Play already. And I thought to myself, you need to spread your love for this wonderful game to more and more people. And that's why I started an English Let's Play again. Oh, look, it's starting to snow. So, yeah, what I wanted to say, I started an English Let's Play again in hope that I can spread my love for the game even further. Because more people can speak English than they can speak German. My English is not the best, but I hope you can understand me a bit. So, and like I said, today we are going over the basics of the game, like resource collecting, what CubeVR is, and it's so beautiful. It's actually pretty nice that we started a new world and it starts to snow. The snow looks wonderful. Okay, let's start with the actual gameplay. When you start a new world, you get a chest right here. Let's open it and see what we got inside. Oops, so, ah, come on, so. So, in here we have 20 processed wood that can come in handy. We will keep it at that. So first we need to collect recipes for crafting equipment like tools and cosmetic items, and we need resources. Your inventory is actually a suitcase. It's really cool. And in the suitcase you have different tabs for inventory, where your inventory is. You have the crafting recipes you already discovered. And as you can see, every question mark recipe is still unknown. There are quite some recipes already. And you have the opportunity to download custom blocks from the Steam Workshop. As you can see, there are currently a total of 146 blocks in the Steam Workshop. And I downloaded 97 of them. They're pretty nice to have. There's stuff like animated water, some Scrabble blocks, and some really awesome stuff. So, then you have a tutorial tab where you can learn the basics of the game, and you have your settings. So, as you can see here, I have two slots. The left slot, where the torch is right now, is the placing slot, and the other slot is for the tools. In the placing slot you have the torch right now, where you can place it like I did, and then you have your tool slot, where you have your tools. Right now we only have the stick, and with this stick we will collect resources. So let's look at our first recipes. As you can see, we only have the stone pickaxe and the stone axe right now. So for both we need stone and some wood. It is pretty easy. You take your stick of damnation, and hit it against the tree until you get your wood. Oh, there it is. As you can see, you can just lift up. And this is your bucket. With the bucket you can place the stuff in your hand or from the world inside your inventory. Zack. It's pretty nice. Let's go with at least 5 wood. So. This one, and here it is. Ooh, we already got 6. So. Actually, I just noticed it looks really cool. The starting place isn't that bad. Right now it's night. Maybe when daybreak we will explore a bit, because it seems pretty nice here. So, oh, as you can see here, that's what a recipe looks like. You can hear a specific sound. Dling. Then you just grab the recipe. Oh, it's a shovel. Stone shovel is pretty nice. What I like the most about Cube VR is the visuals. It's such a beautiful game. Every time I play this game, I am in awe how beautiful it looks. Look at it, deer. It's getting covered in snow. Right now there are only 2 kind of animals in the game. Deer and rabbits. Oh, there's snow in the desert. Let's go back here when the day has come. Let's... Whoa. There's a huge mountain. I can't wait to explore the world. Oh, here's still some. But first I would say we craft some tools. There was an entrance to the underground somewhere around here. I'm pretty sure I saw it. Hmm. It was here somewhere. I'm pretty sure, huh? Hä? I didn't run this far off, did I? Nope. Ah, here it is. Let's place some torches so we can find this spot again. So. Oh, there was actually iron. Nice. So, I just need to get some stones. Nice. So, now I can show you how you make items in this game. You drag the item from your suitcase into the world. You can just drop it. Zack. Ha, did you see? That's actually a really nice feature. Look at the clock. When I hover over it, I can chuck, grab stuff, and pull it to me. Now I lost it. Damn it. So, okay, back to the crafting. You have your recipes, and actually you don't need the recipes if you know how to craft. You can do it from your memories. Let's go with the stone pickaxe first. As you can see, you need 3 wood, that's shown down here, and 3 stone in the shape of a T. So you grab the items you want to combine and just put them together. Let's go into the dark. As you can see, if you can stick them together, they start to get this green outlining. Zack. Zack. And this one. Now it's glowing really green. And if you have it this way, that means that you can craft something with it. In this case, we know that it will be the pickaxe. You just open your bucket and put it inside. I did miss, didn't I? Yep, I did. Where did it go? I lost it. Okay, yeah, that's nothing new for me, because I played the beta version of the game. I sometimes get some strange glitches that never get into the official release of the game, because the developer takes a lot of pride into releasing only total functioning game versions. So this is something that will never happen in the official release. I'm just playing the beta because I'm too impatient to wait till the final release, so I normally test the new features that we got. But hey, we got a stone pickaxe right now, nonetheless. You can take the item, you could track it in the outside world and use it, or you can drop it into the tool slot, and then you can equip it like this. And then we got ourselves a nice stone pickaxe. I would say the next thing we do is a normal axe, so we can gather a lot of wood. We will keep the iron here for now. But I will make a nice entrance so that we can go in and out of this nice mining spot a bit easier. Because I don't want to teleport myself out again. Well, teleporting is a nice thing to say. There are multiple moving options. You can move with locomotion, like I do. I use my left thumbstick to move, and I turn around with my body right now, but you can also move the right thumbstick to move. Ah! I found my pickaxe again. It was stuck in here. And maybe I was too close to the wall and it got stuck in. This never happened to me before. Nice. Well, where was I? At moving. Okay, moving. Yeah. Like I said, I use free locomotion. You can also use teleport. And there are a lot of different, how do you say, options. You can use, like, right now you can just push a button and you have still the option to teleport around. You can even, can you see it? You can see there's a little arrow in the teleport indicator, and I can even move the tip of the arrow, and that shows in which direction I will face when I teleport there. So, okay, I would say we go to explore the vicinity a bit. We just need to remember where the starting point is, because I actually like it here for now. So, there it is. Let's put some torches here so I can find it again. Oh, now I'm out of torches. Okay, to make a torch, we just need some coal. But this actually looks really nice. That's cool. Okay, here is the desert. Ah, look, there are some rabbits. They're pretty cool, aren't they? They are really fluffy. Flip. Okay, let's see. There's only desert here. It sounds like a sandstorm is coming. Let's see what's behind this dune. The music is actually really nice. Ah. Like a little oasis in the desert. That's cute. The world is randomly generated, so every time you start a new game, you get a different world. This is actually my third world that I created. I have a normal world for my German Let's Play. Then I made a new world for a Steam I had a couple of months ago. And now I decided to make an English Let's Play with a new world. Oh, this looks interesting. So I'm pretty interested in what we can find here. This is also one of the best things you can have in CubeVR, just exploring the world, finding new stuff. Okay, I still need to keep. Oh, actually, I think this. Whoa! This mountain is huge! I thought this down there is the top of the mountain, but look! This looks awesome! This is so cool. It's getting evening and this looks so awesome. Ha! Recipe spotted. Oh, seems like the copper pickaxe. there are some other materials you can use to craft your tools, like copper and iron. And the copper tool is more powerful than the stone tool, and the iron tool, is even more powerful than the copper tool. So, there's some coal. Let's see. This looks so awesome. Oh, I can hear a recipe. Ah, there it is.
Oh.
You can, the falling down from higher object can be turned off. I usually turn it off when I'm building something because... Ooh, a shovel. I don't like the fact when I build something like a huge wall or the roof of a house and then I fall down, I have to go all the way up again. This can be pretty annoying, so I turn the falling down off for this instance. But normally I have it on because jumping down a cliff is actually pretty nice. So, there's a lot of desert here. And there's a recipe. Oh, there's another recipe. So two recipes for me. That's nice. Blum. Oh, a chest. Chests are actually the most important thing in this game, because your inventory space is limited, and if you want to build something, you need a lot of space. So, actually, chests are really important. Oh, there's another recipe. Oh, come on. Don't spawn recipes and lure me away. There's another one. Wow. I found a nice spot for recipes. Ooh, a wall stone. Ooh, the sledgehammer. Sledgehammer is a nice item to have to destroy a lot of blocks when you're building some caves, because he has an area of effect where you can destroy a lot of objects at once. Let's see, I saw a cave opening somewhere here. Nope, not this one. Should be around somewhere here. Ah, there. That's it? Yep, that's it. Hey, that's actually really cool. It's like there's a path. Let's just get the coal real quick so I can make some torches. Then we can see what's in here. Coal. Oh, we are almost out of wood. Let's just get the coal. I'm too short. Ah, that's better. I just built something like a podest to stand on, so I can reach the coal. Huh. I can be pretty smart sometimes. So. Ah, that's a nice amount of coal. With this we should be able to get some nice... torches. So, now it's night already. As you can see, the Aurora Borealis is glowing. It's really breathtaking. I love the way this game looks. It's always so nice. So. Let's just take the coal. And I saw we have copper here. It's actually pretty nice. Because I would make a copper axe right now and just skip the stone axe. And we need an axe because we need a lot of wood. So. Come on! I like the way this game is actually bound to the real world logic, because you need to move your arms and swing your arm to actually use your tools. And like here, when you have no room to actually swing your tool, you can't build up any energy and it doesn't work. The immersion in this game is really really nice. It only takes a couple of seconds and you totally forgot that you're inside the game. So, okay, let's get this copper here. So, copper is nice. Nice suit. So, and here. Ah, actually, when you're placing something, you can. Zack. So. Change the area you can place the item. You see? When I make it really short, you can only place where your arm can reach. And you can extend it for like over a meter and a half. So I can even reach the other side of the wall here. That's really handy. It's especially useful when you're building something and you don't want to build like a podest or something to reach it. So. Oh no, I'm out of torches again. That means we need more. Let's just take this one torch. Place it here. So the next thing we have to do is to go outside, get one wood, so we can make an axe. Then we can collect a lot of wood and make the other tools that we need. And then we can start to explore this world. Maybe we can find a place where we want to build our home base. Maybe even just a temporary base. Oh, there's still some copper. Would be a waste to not get it. Is there more? Maybe, maybe? Nope. Okay. Ups. So. Oh, it's put. Oh, the sun is rising. As you can see, the sky is getting brighter. There is iron. To get to use the iron, you need to melt the iron ore first. I also made a video about it, and because you need a lot of stone for the furnace, it's something that I will not do today, because my first priority should be to get some resources. So. What does the recipe say for the eggs? Oh, 4 wood. Okay, need 2 more wood for the eggs. Blub. Blub. Okay. So. And it was 2 copper. So. Wah-ha-ha. So. There it is, a copper axe. Let's just cut down a tree. Look how the sun rays go through the tree tops. It's so awesome. Let's take this one. So. Nice. I can still remember the first time I cut down a tree. I was so astonished when I noticed that you can cut the wood the way you want. Like, I can hit it this way, and zack, as you can see. And now this, and this. So. It's a really cool way to cut down the tree. So. Oh. I chipped a small piece away. If you make the wood too small, it wouldn't count as wood anymore, and you could actually waste a whole tree with this method. If you cut it in super, super tiny little slices, like this, you could actually waste the whole tree. But it's actually pretty cool that you can do this. Like, yeah, as you can see, it's really a super tiny, small piece of nothing. As you could see, it got me 0 wood. What a waste. But you can't use toothpicks to build anything, so it's only natural that you get nothing out of it. So. Nice, 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 nice. Come on. So, anything left? Nope. Goody. Let's. This is awesome. There seems to be a crystal there. Ah, that's right. Crystals are actually something really interesting. They were introduced like a year ago. You can use crystals to power up your bucket. In here, there goes a crystal actually. As you can see, there is a burnout crystal already inside. And you put the crystal in there, and then you can increase the suction rate of your bucket. Or you can even make an air blower out of the bucket. That depends on the kind of crystal you're using. There's a crystal. That's what a crystal looks like. It actually does look like a crystal. So, let's get one. The crystal is a crystal that charges with magical energy or solar energy or whatever. Oh, there's another one. You just have to put the crystal to the world map into the light so it can charge itself. If you charge it at daylight, it becomes a blue crystal like this one. And if you charge it at night, it becomes a red crystal. So, with the blue crystal, you can increase the suction rate of your bucket. And with the red crystal, you get the flowing function for your bucket. And the newest update introduced the function that you can increase the reach of your block placing tool. And now you can even place multiple blocks at once. I can show you how this works. You take the crystal into the hand. There is actually an empty crystal already. The same goes for the bucket, where you just put the crystal in here. Ah, there it is. And as you can see now, the green suction is actually greater than before. So there's the old, and here's the new one. Zack. And now I can place a lot of blocks at the same time. That's actually pretty useful. So. One other nice thing is, if you place multiple blocks at once with this new feature, you sometimes have the chance that there is no block used from your inventory. That's actually pretty nice for all of us who wants to build houses or even castles or bridges or towers or something that needs a lot of stone or other resources. Because now sometimes we don't need to use a resource to place the block. That's actually really nice. Oh, zack, zack, zack. So, come on. So. I came pretty far today. Oops. Oh, we have coal right here beside our base. Wait, shouldn't our base be here? Ah, there it is. It was the other cliff hill thingy. Hill. It's not a cliff, it's a hill. Oh, it looks really interesting. We got a crystal and we get copper right here. There's copper as well. This looks so awesome. Let's go up there. Oh, there's... what? This looks interesting. That's awesome. I just got the feeling that I should build the Lunatic Pandora from Final Fantasy VIII. Recipe! The furnace! Yes! There's another recipe, let's get this. Ooh, two recipes. Oh, nice, 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 nice. Oh, there's one here as well. There! Ooh, the mold. This is so awesome. That's such a nice place. There's a recipe, there are recipes. Nice. So, come on. Iron sledgehammer. This looks so cool. Oh. This is so cool. What do you guys think? Is this cool or is this cool? It's just awesome, isn't it? So awesome. Wow. That's so cool. Wow. I think there was a recipe here as well. Okay. There's a recipe up there. Why? I will never reach you.
What? What?
I have to look where I walk. This is awesome. Can we get up there? I want to get up there. Somehow. Teleport! Yeah. Yeah. There's a recipe. Nice. Iron shovel. That's our base. That's so cool. That's so cool. This is a really nice world. That's nice. This structure is really cool. That is actually a landmark I should be able to remember, so when I get lost, I just have to look for this. I could even... Maybe I can remember my coordinates. My current location is 2083 meters in the X and minus 19 in the Y. So, if I should ever get lost, I just have to watch at the coordinates again. And then I should be able to find my base again. Let's try to get there. Should be possible. Maybe, maybe. if I go this way? Through here? Yes, looks good, looks good. I have to cheat my way. I'm still too far up. Ah, no. Haha. Oof, da. When I get this way, I should be able to get there. Nope. It's just dark. I don't see anything. It's too dark. And I can't teleport to there. That's too far away. There are actually a lot of crystals. Can be useful. We are pretty high up, actually. Let's go back to our base. Whee! Butch. I just heard a recipe. There is this. Huh. At least for today I found my starting point again. Wasn't that hard because I didn't move too far away. But still. Nice. Yeah, well, the surrounding is actually really cool. I will explore it again in the next episode. sorry. I hope you liked this let's play a bit. I hope my English is not too bad, so you can understand a bit of the stuff I say. If you want to say to see more of the let's plays, leave a comment behind, leave a comment below, and all the other stuff like giving a thumbs and the bell and whatever, I don't care. But it would be nice to get some feedback if you want to see the English Let's Play continue or not. I will try to improve myself as well, so maybe that's something we all want to work together with. Well, nonetheless, I'm pretty excited to make this English Let's Play because I want to show to more people how awesome this game is. And I hope I can convey my feelings to you somehow. It's just such an awesome game. And I hope I can see you the next time again. So till then, stay healthy. Bye, see you!